Okay, once again, it's June 30th. It is now 10 o'clock, 10:10 roughly, a.m. 2014. We had rain the other day, and again, it flooded the garden. And I was out here, my wife was out here, and we basically tore the crap out of this thing again, trying to dig trenches. And that's what we're going to have to do if it keeps doing this. You know, I'm sorry. I mean, this is just unusual that so many rains have been as heavy as they have been within a short period of time. And as you can see, look at how this looks. Okay. There's a watermelon right here. I'm not even walking out there because it's too muddy. Watermelon right there. In the shade here, I can see. Okay, there's one growing up right there. No, that's not it. Shoot. Right there. There's another one right there. The double leaves in the middle. And then there's another plant. Let's see if I can find it in there. Right there. Watermelon plant like this one here. So there's four here. I thought I planted five, but who knows. And the trenches we dug here for the tomatoes, so they don't get grounded again because they just starting to come back from the last big flood. Did a fairly decent job of doing it. I'll tell you what, if I could ever afford it, I'd get myself one of them short tillers that goes about 9 inches across just, and just till up in the middle here and make trenches for the rain to go through. I put the seeds in a valley rather than up on a mound, which is my fault. I should have known better all my life. I've known better, but I don't know why I did it like that, and then it floods, and then this is what happens. Then I'm out here trying to shovel the mud off of the plant, you know, get the water down deeper, lower than the plant, and then I'm having to put it in the middle here in the rows, in between the rows. But all my black-eyed peas are up. 8 of them. There's one there, 2 all the way back. All 8. These peas, there's 2 more I got to plant over here. I pulled up the ones that looked like they were coming up, they were dried out. There's a new one right there. New one right there. This one looks like it's dying. I'm going to take these pods off. See these pods right here? There's 4 of these on here. Even though the bottom of it is completely dried out, that's why you see right down here. Let me see if I can get my camera where my cane is at right there. See that? It's brown, like it's dried out. Green up on top here, that's why I don't understand. And the vines are still creeping. So I'm very hesitant about that. That'll be the last thing I do is pull that one up. I'm going to plant one here, because I pulled this one up yesterday. As you can see in the dirt. Oh, I can't see crap. Down there I pulled up the one that was down, it was all dried out. And this one here, it's small, but I don't know if that's gonna, if that's worth keeping it. See the other ones right there, let's come up. So we'll have 7 of these pea plants. Spinach is growing through the grass. See, all this here isn't gonna be yard next year. From this row here over, it's about 12 feet or so, maybe a little bit more, but it's going to just be back to grass. I'm not going to have anything where these peas are or the spinach on it. I mean, this is all going to, I'm going to let grow back up. It's too wide for the little bit that we have out here. Even though we don't have a little, it can be condensed and made better. See, like, we got all that wasted space right there with the dirt. My squash zucchini. We got 1-2 bigger established ones there. They're about 3 weeks old. And then we got 4 in the front there. The 2 in the middle are the most recent ones we just put down. And I gotta be careful not to step in this mud. We planted a couple cantaloupes down here where these stakes are. Nothing yet, same thing here. I mean, they were just put down in the soil. And if it grows, great. If not, well, oh well, we'll try it. Those onions right there, 2 of those had fallen off. The actual stalk like that right there with the onion bunches. And I buried them, I had to bury them. It's not part of natural. This is just once, a couple of them didn't have anything on them. See, the stand, I don't want to get too far in here with the mud. See how I've been digging this up, trying to get the water off of the plants. That's all going to connect eventually. It's going to be like a trench right here. Walk through this. Got a green tomato on that. This is an eggplant right here. They look pretty decent. Again, I can't see the viewfinder. And all the peppers look okay. I don't know if it's on there. Just putting the camera in the general area where the pepper is. These are the ones I had in pots over by the house. They're about 6 to 7, 8 inches tall. That one there got covered with dirt. I don't know if I can see it. Right there. I'm not gonna mess with that one there. That one there. This is gonna be connected. I gotta tear all this up later. Then we got these others. This is one of the real hot peppers right here. I can't see on here, so right there is one of the hot peppers. These are like green or orange bell peppers. This other smaller one here is the real hot pepper too. It's on there somewhere right by the steak. Got a couple jalapeno peppers. Okay, there's another tomato, that's the second tomato. Again, I can't see it on here, but there's right there. And that one over there, that tomato plant's got two tomatoes on it. I can't see on the viewfinder. Here's two tomatoes on this one. They're about the size of golf balls. And then we got more peppers right here, here. And I got a tomato plant outside this one. This is no cage on this one. The cherry tomatoes have got about 10 cherry tomatoes on there already. Okra. Over here by the house. Lucy, little bitch, get your butts over here now! Lucy! Sorry, dogs are off in the field. Get over here! Spray that crap with Monsanto shit. Excuse my mouth. Poison. Okay. That's a Cherokee something tomato. These should all be like green bell peppers and orange bell peppers. Except for a short one down here again. It's another hot pepper. That one by the steak. See that little one down there? Get out away from there, Petey. That's a hot pepper. Petey, come on. Come out of there. Come out of there. Get out of the garden. So anyway, some of these, this one here with the steak is about 10 inches tall. I can't see in the viewfinder, but it is there somewhere. And, got a heck out of some of that grass there near the back. But we got the eight pepper plants here, the Cherokee tomato, and then that. God, I can't see. Shoot. So next year it'll be 40 feet that direction and only 28 feet across. So it'll stop where those beans are over there. So anyway, hopefully, if the country is here next year. So that's it.